Cam, just kind of, you know, talk kind of through your development with Coach Arbuckle and what you've kind of learned from him and kind of how your guys' relationship is built.
Oh, it's been great. Him coming in with his family, his little son, it's been great getting able to talk to him more than just football, learn more about his background, coming from the Southland Conference, coming from Houston Christian now. So just being able to learn more about him, him helping me in my progression as I learned the new concepts of the offense, him helping me refine my footwork. So being more of just a stable quarterback than just taking what the defense gives me, also just being needy, not greedy.
You know, for you last year when you came in, kind of was your first spring ball and getting used to the Power 5 level, obviously kind of familiarizing yourself with a bunch of different things. How do you feel like it's different here in year two now that you kind of, you know, the school, you know, the system, you know, the team, you know, kind of the, what the Pac-12 is like?
It's just going with the same mindset every day, I would have to say. The team, we all know each other. We all know what everyone brings to the table. We know who can step up and make plays at big time moments, who knows who's going to bring that camaraderie around. So really it all just comes down to bringing the same mindset every day. And that's just translating to everyone on the team, every position room.
You're throwing to a pretty, you know, new crop of receivers, very few returners. I mean, you talk about Link, obviously, Zion, Orion, Layton, but, you know, a lot of transfers, some young guys. What have you kind of seen from some of the new faces?
Just the ability for them to learn. They've been able to pick up this offense within the first couple of weeks since they got here in January. Starting with Kales, he's going to be one of our good targets on the outsides, to Kyle Williams, to DT. So just getting them up to speed, getting them to the fast-paced style of the offense, because once we go tempo, I feel like that's where we can have trouble with the new receivers. So just getting that new formality, that new terminology to them, I think we'll have a great outcome.
What was your kind of individual priority for yourself this offseason? And, you know, when Dicker talks about, you know, getting your feet and arm in sync, and could you kind of just walk us through what that means and what you made sure to highlight this offseason?
Just having a consistent drop. A lot last year, I was more of a backpedaler, so I switched foot forward, now I'm going right foot forward. So maintaining a three-step drop or a shuffle, whichever drop I have on that concept. Then also just getting off reads quicker. We canceled a lot of front side reads just pre-snap this year, which I love. So getting through reads quicker, refining footwork, and that's something that I've seen a difference since January, first getting back here, all the way to leading to the first day of spring ball.
And just in terms of the offensive system, is how many, you know, I guess, new learning points are there? And, you know, what are some of the new quirks of this offensive system from year to year that maybe you enjoy the most, or just kind of new things to expect from this offense?
The biggest learning was just the new terminology. It's a lot of the same concepts. I'll probably say we have more intermediate concepts than what we had last year. So the terminology is a little bit different signals on some of them. So that's been the biggest challenge to the quarterback room, is just learning that and then just trying to translate it out here.
Hey, Cam, good to see you. Would you say for the offense, the main goal of spring ball is to you know, just hammer home the new offense, or is there something else and that can, you know, you have all summer and part of the fall to work on that?
I think our main goal is just compete every day. We know we're going to have busts all the way from here all the way to day 15. So it's really just competing every day, showing you're better than the person in front of you, and just trying to go earn a spot.
This time last year, you know, you're coming in, a lot of guys you didn't know. I just wonder, how does the pressure or familiarity, or how does that feel this year compared to last year?
It doesn't feel any different. I don't really believe in pressure. I feel like everyone has a job. The ball's in my hands every play, so I know I'm the biggest decision maker on the team. So just keeping ball security, having same mindset, giving everybody no bad body language, no bad language at all. So just having just a great group around you, I would say. Just, and then once we all put it together at the end of the spring, I feel like it leads towards the season.
Your coach has talked a lot about it, new wide receivers early on. How do you kind of want to establish that relationship in spring ball heading into the fall?
Just throwing more outside of spring ball. We threw a lot in 7-on-7 PRPs leading up to this moment, and then also just hanging out with each other. Some of the new transfers come over to my house, or I go to theirs, or we're just chilling the weekend. So just getting to know them a little bit more outside of football, because at the end of the day, we're all human. So I feel like if I can know them more on a personal level, it'll translate out here to the field.
And then what are some things you want to hone in on in your game specifically in spring ball? What do you want to improve and work on?
My pocket movement. I have to say, it was sometimes last year, sacks count as O-line, but I know watching film, that one was on me, whether it's stepping up in the pocket or just getting out too early. So that's probably one of the biggest things I want to work this spring.